not only the world has ever seen, but that the world will ever see. I think he is the greatest cricketer, as we say, on Earth, on Mars, and on Venus. And there is nothing going to take that away. And his name is none other than his right excellent Sir Gary Sobers. Someone who is as humble as they come, who has just allowed his God-given talent, his love for the game, and his sense of decency to take him to the top of the world in that sport. And I suspect you can go into any sport. You have a Muhammad Ali, you have a Pele, you may have a Bob Greasy or Joe Montana or whoever, but even those guys, to my mind, they're just about a step behind Sir Gary Sobers.
Wow, well, I stand corrected.
Also represented at the opening of the park in Broward was the West Indies Cricket Board, the body that has for many years been responsible for selecting the players who represent the West Indies on the international stage. Dr. Donald Peters, CEO of the WICB, gave some glowing reviews of the facility.
Well, I was invited here by the people of the city to meet to the opening of this new ground. We think it's a very impressive ground. It's an internationally recognized ground because now you can play international cricket in Lauderdale and in this county.
You're here to help promote or to build the cricket fan base here. You know, tell me more about, you know, your involvement in all of this, and how do you plan to bring this to fruition?
Well, cricket is the second most popular game in the world. There are millions of people playing it. For instance, India has a population of 1.4 billion people and is the most exciting cricketing nation in the world. The West Indies have been the cricket world champion for 1.5 decades. We're not doing so good now, but we get on our way back to the top. And the population on the east coast of North America is almost 1.9 million West Indians. And Indians, Pakistanis, Australians, 12 nations play cricket. That represents almost 2.5 billion people playing cricket. So the Americans have been left out of cricket, so there are 300 million people. We figure we can help teach them cricket. And maybe they'll win. They're very good at things. They take people game and they beat up on them. So we figure if we bring cricket to this part of the world, then maybe it'll be a new thing that the Americans can beat us at.
And as an American, we're looking forward to doing that.
No, I don't think that's possible, but you can try.
Now tell me, we've been bidding for the World Cup and you guys kind of beat us out. Tell me a little bit about, you know, the World Cup and us.
Well, you guys were not that good, so we beat you at it. We're pretty smart people in the West Indies, so we had an edge. At least we play cricket better, you have snow, and of course you have beaches just like us. So I think you have a good shot again the next time around, but maybe you should talk to us first.
Well, that's why we have you here, so let's talk.
Well, you're very smart. That's cool. Well, this town is very astute because they brought me here. We got the last World Cup, it's worth millions and millions of dollars, and I know you guys love money, so next World Cup, maybe here. But seriously, we think that if we bring international cricket here, a number of things happen for this county and the state. One is the revenue base increases. Secondly, you expose to international cricket and the city diversity of this town. And thirdly, the young kids that I saw today can begin to understand there's a new game in which they can become professionals. The top cricket person in the world, Tendulkar from India, is probably grossing $6.9 million a year. Well, we have players in the West Indies grossing almost $1 million a year. And so there's money in it. It's another professional sport. It's a popular sport. It's sometimes long, but now we have a new version which completes in one day, and the 2020 which completes in about 4 hours.
So the West Indians certainly seem positive about the future of cricket here in America and about the ability to get Americans interested in the sport. But what about the Americans? What are we saying about our cricketing future?
I'm an American football is my heart. I'm not going to tell a lie. And everybody knows that. I'm a Hurricane. When we began looking into the possibilities and that the cricket facility portion of this multipurpose stadium would bring to the city of Lauderhill, I was really fortunate. The city of Lauderhill sent me to a few different countries, Trinidad and Tobago. I've been to St. Lucia, Barbados. And I've got to really get to know the people who are involved in cricket and the locals that you see around here at this grand opening today. They're so passionate about their sport, and for that I had to get more information, and I had to find out what is it about this sport that these people are so in love with. And once I got to know the people and I realized the economic development that it could bring to this area that is in need of redevelopment, I thought this is the kind of component that could make the city come alive in terms of its economics. And it has brought almost $1 billion in redevelopment in the surrounding area. So I'm very proud of all the pieces, parts of it, not just the cricket stadium, but also all the other pieces of the 110-acre park. I'm very proud of the community that has fought to make sure all these pieces, parts are here. But I'm really excited about what it means to the economics of our city and how it's going to revitalize it. It's going to be the heart of Broward County in terms of tourism. And it's exciting to have international press coming around and we have people flown in here today from all over the place, Dominica and Trinidad and Jamaica. So it's already bringing the components of tourism that we had hoped it would be. And I'm excited for the people who live in Broward County who will call this facility home. And I think they deserve that moment in the sun too. I am Italian. We play bocce. And, you know, everybody has their sport and everybody should be able to partake in that, and I'm happy about that.
Tell me something. As an American, you've seen the sport. Tell me, what do you know about cricket?
Okay. Well, I've been around this circle now for about 6 years. I've actually gotten to see some. I went to the World Cup, and I've seen, I've actually even seen tests. I've actually even seen the West Indies win, which I think is exciting because I know they're having a hard time right now. I actually have learned to love the game. I think it's very fast in spite of what people think. And I want to say one thing about Americans, because everybody says Americans are never going to embrace cricket, and I think that's baloney. And let me tell you why. We follow several day sports. We follow golf for several days. We follow NASCAR for several days. And when we get a U.S. team that could do a little butt kicking, and everybody knows me, I'm very to the point, we get a U.S. team that's strong and could beat some other teams, you look out, America, because we're going to be playing cricket too, and we're going to have a good team someday. So I think Americans are perfectly capable and have a good attention span to be good at any sport. So go USA.
Well, it may take some time, but I do have to agree with Leslie that in America, we love to win, and I have no doubt that in the not-too-distant future, we will join places like Australia, Pakistan, India, and the Caribbean on that list of the world's greatest cricket nations. Just how quickly we get there? Well, it's up to you and your level of support. Right now, Australia is sitting at number one in the world, but I'd say America has what it takes to dethrone them.
Next week on Cricket Corner USA, find out how Broward County almost created history on the world cricket stage, and we'll tell you why investors are excited about the returns this $70 million project is projected to bring in. We'll also have more movers and shakers from the international cricket stage, and they all agree that the future for cricket in Florida is bright. If it is cricket news you're looking for, we've got the scoop right here on Cricket Corner USA. So be sure to tune in next week and every Saturday morning at 9:30 a.m. for all of the cricketed news, tips on how you can improve your game, and best of all, interviews with the legends, some of the greatest men to take to the cricket pitches around the world. Watch us on Comcast Cable on Channel 19 in North Dade, Channel 79 in South Broward, and Channel 76 in North Broward. Don't you miss it, because I'm sure you will be bowled over. I'm Melanie Burke, and you've been watching Cricket Corner USA. On behalf of the entire Cricket Corner USA team, here's hoping you have a wonderful weekend.